Welcome back to Spinning the Past. Today I'm going to be assessing some of the fleeces that I have. I talked about in another video, but I kind of wanted to show you. See my little t-shirt. When I look at a fleece, I'm kind of looking at it like this. Different parts of the fleece may be better for certain things than another. And it says divide and conquer. That's on this t-shirt. But today I wanted to show you, if I can get this to turn around, I wanted to show you the fleeces and then how I assess them. So here we have, this is a Rambouillet that I spoke about in another video. And I'm just trying to get this little thing on here, this little glove. But I wanted to show you this Rambouillet fleece. This is also a Rambouillet. They're the same weight, but you can see how this staple length and the crimp is very different than this one. This looks to me more like a Rambouillet. This looks like it has a cross with Lincoln. So I'm gonna ask him whether or not that's the case. I could be wrong about that, but you can just, there's a huge difference. You can see the fine crimp on here. So when I go through the fleece, what I'm gonna do right now is I'm going to shake. Do you see all the little bits that are coming out? You see this? These little bits here. These little bits here are second cuts. That's when the shearer went over a second time to make sure that the fleece was all even and there weren't little, you know, bunches of fleece that didn't get shaved on the sheep. So I want to show you over here because I think there's more here. So if I shake it, these little bits are going to cause nips and oils in your spinning. So these are not our friends. So now is the time, before they get mixed in with everything, is to take them out now and shake them. So here's one here. So good shears are pretty good about not doing that. And some shears just don't care. They just want to get the animal done. So these little bits, you see when I shake it out, these little things I'm gonna sweep up. You see that? I'm gonna sweep those up. And I'm gonna do the same here. Shake, 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 shake. And we have some down here. Another thing I'll do when I'm here with the fleece is I'll kind of, you know, does it have any of those little tags? Any of the little poo things? And in general, how does it look? How does it look? So the nips are the, see the noils that are, they're on the bottom end, the cut end. So I need to do some shaking and everything. And then I'll sweep and then I'll shake again. This one I'm not gonna, let's see, there's a critter there. I'm not gonna break into different parts, but on that other one that had a lot more distinction between different parts, I might. So, like I said in my other video, that there's some parts that are really short, very curly. This fleece here, I found this. So, you know, these little nips and oils, these little things like that, I called kind of third class. And I will keep those. Wow, look at all that kemp in there. Kemp are the little white. Look at all that. That's not good. Kempy fleeces are not good. So I will wash this totally separate. I divide them into, like, you know, a first class, second class, third class wool. This one I may not do that, but, you know, I'll go through and see if I have bits like this. I don't know if you can see the little, I don't know if it's better. It's kind of hard to see with the sunlight. Maybe there. These little white, little prickly things, that prickly things are things that used to poke out on people and cause kind of a scratchiness. So really don't want that next to your skin. However, what I do with these things, and the third class of the third sort, and that's just me, I will take this, wash it just so it gets a bit clean, and then I will use this as batting. So I need to make some batting for, I guess they're called draft snakes, things you put under your door. I need to make some that goes on up on the side. There's a lot of drafts in different the entrances of this house. So I'm gonna collect these, wash them, sew a little case. I haven't decided whether it's gonna be cotton, or maybe I'll use some sort of waterproof thing. And then I will use this to stuff it. So all parts of the wool, just like my little shirt showed, has a purpose. Now, these other little second cuts, I will just go off here, and then I will let nature take care of it. That's great bedding for mammals, and great bedding and a good mulch for around here. Another thing that you could do if you're washing this outside is, you know, if you have the, you know, the, sometimes I do this, it really depends. If I have a garden going, and if I have, like I said, I put the first batch just in water to soak, I may dump that into my garden or something, because there's a lot of organic material in that, and that'll just, you know, kind of the cycle of life. Just kind of, that goes back into the soil, that will nurture the soil. And so, yeah. And then this over here, as you can see, is very, very, this is Lincoln. This is Lincoln long wool, so it's a long staple. But as I said in the earlier, there's a poopy thing. As I said, it's, you know, these locks should come off kind of almost individually. And they're kind of stuck together. They're kind of quasi-felted together. So I'm gonna work on that. And another thing to notice, and it's, even though he said he coated these, I'm still finding, you know, this VM. VM stands for vegetative matter. So this is not, I don't really like this in my fleeces, especially for the prices that I paid for these. But, and they won't come out. You would think you could shake it, you know, get some crumbs down there, but some of this is absolutely embedded. And that's why this length of wool, remember the 3.5 inch rule, that you will want to definitely use combs on. So as you comb these locks, and that's going to be hard because if it's cutted like this, when it gets in the water, it's going to felt. And so these little things, I'll have to be very careful, are going to felt. And it's going to be really, really hard to get these apart. These will go through. And then some of that, so here's the little VM there, the little particles. And, you know, they're outside animals. They're living animals. So, you know, they're going to roll in straw. So look at that. So that should come out in hand combs. Maybe a little bit in the wash process. But right now, I'm going to spend time shaking. Shake, 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 shake. This, you see that this, a lot of this is about the same type of wool. We're not having a lot of variations as we did in that first Rambouillet. So, yeah. So this too has second cuts, so you can see these. Here's the second cuts down here. So again, I will bag those up. Those would be, I'll write on their third sort. That's just the way I do it. Everyone does it differently. Some people don't even bother. Some people just wash all of it together. But this is, I found that this is a good time to get this sorted out. So again, I will wash these. This is always good for stuffing toys. For, like I said, I use it kind of as anything I would use batting, polyester batting for, I can use this for. These are great for little nooks and crannies that you need to seal up for the winter. You can put these, wash these, put these in little cat toys. I'll do a separate video on, 10 things you can do with the second cuts or the lesser quality parts of the fleece. So this is kind of damp. I can feel it even through these gloves. And I do wear gloves because these critters have been outdoors and there's all kinds of, you don't know what you're going to find when you open up these fleeces. So, there's poopy stuff in it and stuff like that. So, but not too bad, not too bad. So I've got my work cut out. I'm going to get all three, 1, 2, 3, sorted today. I'm going to shake them out. I'm going to sort them in piles. Like I said, that one I will definitely do sort by staple length, that one. This one has more consistent staple length, just a cursory view of it. I will sort out the piles, like I said, maybe things I don't want, I'll put in my third class, and then I'll put the second class, and then I'll put the first class in separate little piles, and then I will go back, and then I will go through those and kind of put them in little bags, label the bags, and say the breed of them, first, second, third. I might even say, if it's legs, I have done in the past, if it's a leg or a side or a neck, if this was, better preserved in the way it was on the sheep. And again, the staple length will also play a role into that. So I will get it first, third, second, and first, and then I will divide the first up into approximately 1 pound batches, and then I'll bag those, and then I'll put the second in the second bags, and then I'll put the thirds into a third sort bag. And then that will be prep for eventually washing. Again, I'm going to do that on this fleece, and so hopefully it's going to take me a good hour or so to do this, because it's just a lot of fleece to go through, but hey, every little bit helps. It's a beautiful day out today, and so hopefully when I come back, I will show you. I don't know how to add things. I don't know how to edit so I can add things to this video. I don't have any editing software. But maybe in another video or something, I might have my little bag set up in a row, or I'll try to insert a picture of kind of the end process. So there you go. Sorting the fleeces. Rambouillet, Lincoln. And then I'll have another video showing you Shetland, Corriedale, and Jacob, how to do those fleeces. So thanks so much for joining me on Spinning the Past.